Welcome to our Piping Engineering YouTube channel. We continue our free piping education videos in this channel. Before starting this video, please subscribe to our education YouTube channel to watch more piping engineering videos. In this video, we will show step by step how to calculate the distance between the centers of the elbows in the pipeline, the cut elbow's length, and the length of the pipe piece between these elbows in the piping isometric drawing. Let's start the pipe tutorial video. We will perform the calculations in this video on a 6-inch piping isometric drawing. In order to understand the work more easily, I have additionally prepared a 3D model view of this pipeline. To find the length of the pipe piece between these two elbows, first we must calculate the distance between the centers of the elbows. On next stage, we need to find the lengths of the 6-inch cut elbows, and finally from the total length between the centers of the elbows we will subtract the lengths of the cut elbows and the gaps for welding. Let's go step by step. As you can see, 6-inch pipeline comes first horizontal then vertical up with 13.8 degree or 250 millimeters and then continue horizontally again. At the same time, the pipeline has turned 12.5 degree or 220 millimeters to the left horizontally looking from the second elbow to the first elbow. To make it easier to understand the turn of the pipeline from the second elbow, the turn part of the pipeline is shown inside the parallelogram. So that the first elbow in the pipeline is located in the lower right corner of the parallelogram and the second elbow is located in the upper left corner of the parallelogram. Two right triangles are formed with dashed lines after the pipeline rises vertically obliquely and turns 220 millimeters to the left from the second elbow. The hypotenuse of the vertically blue right angle triangle is the distance between the elbows in the pipeline. Let's mark the hypotenuse of this vertical blue right angle triangle with big letter H. Now let's begin to find the big letter H, which is the hypotenuse of the vertical right angle triangle. We will use the trigonometric function formula in such cases to calculating the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle. According to the trigonometric function, sin 13.8 degrees will be equals 250 divided by h. We find that sin 13.8 degrees equals 0.2385 using a scientific or telephone calculator. We substitute the value of sin 13.8 degrees in the above equation. Then 0.2385 will be equals 250 divided by h. From here h will be equal to 250 divided by 0.2385. Using the calculator, we find that h will be equal to 1048 millimeters. 1048 millimeters is the hypotenuse of the vertically blue right triangle and is also the distance between the centers of the 6-inch but weld elbows. So, the overall length between the centers of the but weld cut elbows is 1048 millimeters. If we subtract the lengths of the cut elbows and the gaps for welding from this total length, we can find the length of the blue color pipe section. Now let's calculate cut elbows angles. First, we complete each elbow from the back to a right-angled triangle, provided that they are on the same plane. Let's paint one of them with blue color and the other with red color. And mark the lower elbow cutting angle with A and the upper elbow cutting angle with B. Remove the extra lines of the parallelogram to see the calculations more clearly. Let's start calculating the cutting angle of the following elbow first. In a blue right triangle, one of the perpendicular sides, that is, the length of the opposite side, is 995 millimeters. The length of the hypotenuse is 1048 millimeters. According to the trigonometric function, sinus a degree will be equals 995 divided by 1048. We find that 995 divided by 1048 equals 0.9494 using a calculator. Using the calculator, we find that arcsinus 0.9494 approximately will be equal to 72 degrees. So we calculated and found that the cutting angle of the following elbow is 72 degrees. Now let's start calculating the cutting angle of the second elbow on the top. The adjacent side in a red right triangle is 220 millimeters. The length of the hypotenuse is 1048 millimeters. According to the trigonometric function cosinus b degree, will be equals 220 divided by 1048. We find that 220 divided by 1048 equals 0.2099 using a calculator. Using the calculator, we find that arcosinus 0.2099 approximately will be equal to 78 degrees. So we calculated and found that the cutting angle of the top elbow is 78 degrees. Now let's calculate the dimensions of these elbows from the center to the end. Formula for calculating center to end distance of such cut elbows is as follows. Elbow length is equals tangent, elbow degree divided by 2, multiplying 1.5, multiplying nominal pipe size of elbow NPS, multiplying 25.4. For this formula 6 inch 72 degree, but weld elbow length is equals tangent 72 divided 2 multiplying 1.5, multiplying 6, multiplying 25.4. We used scientific calculator and found 6 inch 72 degree, but weld elbow length is equals 166 millimeters. Now calculate second elbow center to end dimension. For this formula 6 inch 78 degree, but weld elbow length is equals tangent 78 divided 2 multiplying 1.5, multiplying 6, multiplying 25.4. We used scientific calculator and found 6 inch 78 degree, but weld elbow length is equals 185 millimeters. Now, look at the fit-up process pipe fittings each other in this pipeline. During fit-up, such are open between the pipe fittings to be welded, and a gap of approximately 3 millimeters. Having this gap is for better root welding. We should take these gaps into account when calculating the length of the red color pipe section. Pipe length is equal, total length 1048 millimeters, minus 6 inch 72 degree, but weld elbow length 166 millimeters, minus 6 inch 78 degree, but weld elbow length 185 millimeters, and minus 2 times gaps for welding 3 millimeters. At last we calculate and found length of 6 inch red color pipe section on this pipe line is 691 millimeters. By using this method, you can easily calculate pipe length and cut an elbow to any degrees in the pipelines. This tutorial video is finishing here. If you liked our video, please subscribe Piping Engineering YouTube channel. For help the development of this education channel, is very important our friends' supports, likes and comments. Thank you for watching. See you on next video. Take care.